Thanks for joining me. Today we are going to make a tossed breadfruit. Now I'm going to cut my breadfruit into small pieces, and once it is boiled, we're going to cut them into bite-sized pieces. Normally we won't do something like a tossed breadfruit. With breadfruit, we'll make something more like an oil dong, or just simply boil it and have it with some type of chicken or sauce or whatever. So after peeling and washing my breadfruit, I have boiled it. Once it is soft, I am not going to leave it this size. This size you're seeing here is typically used if you're making an oil dong. As I said, we're not making that, we're making a tossed breadfruit. So I'm going to cut it into smaller pieces, and this is the size that I cut my breadfruit into. And I'm going to my garden and I'm going to pick up some herbs just to make some seasoning to add to this pot. And you could use whatever types of seasoning you use, what you would like to use. And I am going to leave the list of all what I use to make my little quick seasoning. So I had some onion and all my other herbs that I just picked up from my garden. I also had a sweet pepper that I picked up, and some rosemary that I dried also. So I'm adding no water to this because I don't want it to have too much of liquid. So this is a stew that I made previously. That recipe is coming up. So I'm going to use it as the base for this sauce. You don't have to. You could use something else. You can use water, but we will discuss that more in this recipe that is coming up with that sauce. So the ingredients I'm using is carrots, sweet pepper, tomato, and I'm going to use some hot pepper. But what I love to do, I would like to buy a lot of hot pepper in bulk, and I would clean them properly and freeze them, and when I need one, I just take up one and use it. So I'm going to also use some coconut milk. I'm going to use a cup of coconut milk. I'm going to strain it directly into the pot, one cup. As I said, I don't want it too watery because remember our breadfruit is already cooked, so we're not going to cook anything. We're going to toss it into this sauce that I am making with the base from the stew that I made previously. As I mentioned, that stew sauce will be coming up in a recipe, and I will link the two videos together so you could go back and watch. All right, so after straining the coconut milk and I leave it to boil, I didn't add any excess amount of seasoning in this because, as again, the stew that I previously made was perfectly seasoned, and I am really trying to control the amount of sodium, so I did not need to add any more salt. All I added was some black pepper. So once my sauce has thickened up the way I would like it, I'm just going to lower the fire completely and toss my breadfruit into the sauce. Just toss it around, and I am leaving the fire on very low heat, and I'm just going to let it sit and simmer there for a couple of minutes. For the most I left that there was for about 5 minutes, and then I removed it because I didn't want it too dry. I wanted some of the sauce so when I'm eating, you know, it isn't dry. Right, so that's what I did, and this is how I had my breadfruit. Normally we would make oil dong or breadfruit chips, or we'll just boil the breadfruit, and we would have this with like a stewed chicken, curry fish, whatever type of meat, sauce, beans. Right, we could have it like that. So I wanted to toss it in a sauce and just do something different with it, and it was very delightful. I am glad I used the remainder of my stew that I made previously as the base for this. I would try this again with some coconut milk as the base and then season as I go and see how that will turn out. But this way was really nice, and as I said, how I made that sauce, that stew, in the recipe that's after this video. So look out for that stew. Thanks for watching.